Hey guys, what's up? This is Edgemeister, and I know it's been a while since I've done a face cam video here, but yeah, here it is. So today we're actually going to go ahead and start up a new series called The Quest for Something, you know? Except for, it's not just called The Quest for Something, it's The Quest for Blank. And the thing we're looking for in the quest is the loner.rebel hand cannon. This is a year one hand cannon that can only be obtained from endgame Prison of Elders loot. And yeah, it's basically an Ice Luna with some worse stats, but it has battle. You can roll it with Battle Runner, and I kind of want to see how that's going to play out. So yeah, I'll put it up on the screen right now. And we're going to go ahead and look for that bad boy. So we're going to launch up a game of level 28 Prison of Elders. I'm going to turn off my webcam, so, because I'm just going to be looking over here anyways at my screen. So, yeah, I will do that. What we're going to be using today here is, we're going to use some classic stuff here. We're going to use the Fatebringer, which is really nice. I just realized I should probably put some solar thing on here. Maybe Saladin's Vigil. Yeah, we'll put on Saladin's Vigil. Or this guy. Yeah, this guy I've been trying to use in PvP a little bit. This is also a year one rare weapon. It looks pretty cool. Lots of the old rares look really cool. And it's not too bad. Comparing to the Ethesian, Ethesian is better in almost every way. This guy actually has more range than the Ethesian, and the Ethesian doesn't really get any range perks, and it does charge just a little bit faster, but Ethesian just, it has better stats for basically anything here, and this roll is pretty damn good as well. But it's an alright gun. I've cross-snapped people with this guy, just like I have with Ethesian, so it's fun, it's a fun gun for sure. And yeah, so we're using full on all three burns. I miss doing this. It was a blast. So Prison of Elders is something that I would rather kind of not do. Potatoes. I usually do play with potatoes. In this. So let's see if we do. Prison of. I don't know how edited I'm gonna edit the series here, but yeah. So this first season's gonna be at the quest for the Loner Rebel hand cannon. The next one, I'm thinking it's either going to be for the Light Beyond Nemesis Fusion Rifle and Crota, or maybe a nice God Roll Lord High Fixer, or a nice God Roll. Ooh, he just disappeared. What am I thinking of? A Mago Loop. Try to, you know, it's never going to be good as Year One Fatebringer back in Year One. Like, I'm just using it because nostalgia, it is definitely not anywhere as good as it used to be. Ooh, that's gonna be badass. So let's just go ahead and play some PvE. I don't play much PvE, I'm usually a PvP player. Did I not get Outlaw to proc? Did I not hit him in the stomach? There we go. Outlaw and Firefly. Best freaking combination ever. And back in year one, this is the only hand cannon that could have that combination. You could get it on scout rifles, I think, but not on hand cannons. Whoops. And back in the day, you didn't really need scout rifles. So hand cannons kind of filled the role of scout rifles. It was easier to aim them at farther ranges when it came to scout rifles. But when it comes to hand cannons, like, they used to have basically the amount of range. Like, if you're wondering why people were freaking out, like, oh, the initial accuracy went back to year one. Yeah, in year one, you could get some pretty good, crazy initial accuracy stats. I love fusion rifles. I don't even have to do this, what I'm doing right now. It's just fun. Ooh. Oh, that wasn't Odila. Yeah, I also want to talk a little bit about, kind of what I'm going to be doing next week. You see, I'm actually on a 6-day work week, which kind of sucks. I'm going to be getting another one of those pretty soon here, so not too many videos, not too very well-edited videos, you know. but I'll try. I'm trying with this series. I just need some nice Destiny series. Try to get along with some Halo stuff, because when Destiny 2 comes out, I'm going to be doing a lot of Destiny. I'm doing a lot of Halo right now, but I want to try to space both of those out, so I'm not just doing one or the other. That's kind of an issue I've had before, so I don't want to repeat the same mistakes and just go one or the other. I'm going to try to do both Destiny and Halo, because that's fun. Get out of my way, bro. Fine, you do whatever you want. What was I gonna say? Oh yeah, so next week, there is a very high chance that I'm gonna go out and buy myself a nice Nintendo Switch. So my channel is gonna still stay a Halo Destiny channel, but if you want to see some Switch games in there, I can definitely do that. If I do end up buying it, I'm going to get it with The Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild, because that game looks pretty damn awesome. If you haven't looked at it, go ahead and look at it. If you're thinking like, oh, I just play on Xbox or I just play on PlayStation, you know, I wouldn't ever think about getting a Nintendo system. Just check out Breath of the Wild. It looks pretty darn good. Oh, Trickle. I hate Trickle. Especially with the build that I'm on. Grenadier. This is my fun build. Basically lifesteal build. You know, you use the nothing manacles. I don't have max discipline for some reason, but you use max discipline. And then you use lifesteal, hunger, embrace the void. And, yeah. You basically can get infinite grenades for fairly fast. Especially if Grenadier's on. If Grenadier's on, then... spawn right in there. Okay, this round I'm going to go ahead and equip this ghost. The ghost. You can't go wrong with the ghost. Ghost that looks like a ghost. Yeah, this round really sucks, and this is kind of the place where most of the potatoes show their potato-y they are. Basically, we should always have one person, on all sides, one over here, one over there, and the one in the middle. I usually stay around here, because this is the one that most people they'll just forget about it, because when it comes to dismantling the mines, which is, almost every single time it's dismantled the mines, there's a mine I didn't dismantle, there's one over here. There's one in the middle over there, and then there's one over on the balcony over there. And it really sucks when there's one over there, and then it comes over here, and everyone's over there, and it's like, just go stand on the zone. That's all you really need to do, and they just don't do it. And it drives me insane. So let's see what it is. Hopefully it is, an important target or something that potatoes can actually complete. Important target, nice. So I'm gonna go over to where the important target spawns and we're actually gonna do it. So this is very, very doable with potatoes. Especially with my Fatebringer here, just taking out his shields freaking crazy person. You know what? I'll just do that. I'll just get rid of him right there. Why not? Now we just gotta clear out enemies. But yeah, the dismantle mines is the absolute worst on this. On any other map, it's pretty fine, but when it comes to this, it's just... Man, it sucks. It just sucks. Ooh, orb. Thanks for the orb. Orb's gonna be really useful on the trickle here. Ooh, I'm gonna be able to get my super again just from that. Thank you, sir! You guys are so far proving not to be potatoes, but... Then again, if we went on here with Dismantle the Mines, then that would kind of suck. Are you going to pick it up? I'll pick it up. Alright, so let's... Are you kidding me? It's right here. I might have to use my super on it. Where is the important target? There he is. Yeah, I'm just gonna super him right when he comes out. There we go.
Success.
You have done it. Yeah, I like this room with Fatebringer though. I'm gonna just use Fatebringer. Because of the arc burn. It's pretty convenient. So let's just clear this out, and that is probably the fastest fallen room I've ever done. The fallen room is the worst, because it is usually always discounted the mines. Yeah, so let's go through here. And by the way, I'm still gonna do some things off camera. But if I do get it, I'll make sure my capture card's always running when I'm doing these. So that when I actually get the Loner Rebel, then I'll be like, hey, there is me getting the Loner Rebel, and I'll probably record like some backup or just put it on to like another episode. So like I'll always have an episode recorded until I record the next one, I think is what I'm gonna do. That might be the easiest way. Yeah. Ooh. Nothing but net. I might also do this in different characters, but I just enjoy doing this the most on a Voidwalker Warlock. That's just my favorite. My favorite fun class, and Prison of Elders for me isn't very fun, so I honestly would want to use the most fun class to use, which I think is Voidwalker Warlock with nothing manacles, set up with grenades, so we can just, you know, spam those grenades on people. Kill them back. Okay, sir, I will do that with my extra melee damage. That is nice. That will be nice. Especially on the character with the, or the class with the longest melee. Yeah, I should also talk a little bit about Destiny 2, because that is on the horizon. Or at least the announcement. It's going to come out this year, and if it doesn't, if they do delay it, then all it does is hurt them, because they'll actually lose a big chunk of money. I don't know the exact details here, but I do know that they are not going to be happy if they decide to delay it until next year. And that is good and bad. It's good because I freaking want Destiny 2 to come here. But it's bad because we see how Destiny 1 turned. I'm gonna melee this guy. But he's weak anyways. We've seen how Destiny 1 turned out, where they had some issues with the development. Oh jeez! They had issues with development, and then, you know, it kind of turned into not the game they wanted it to be. Putting it, you know, in simplest terms. And we've heard things that, well, I've heard that they've also had some issues with Destiny 2. Come on. Okay, so we gotta destroy these mines. I don't mind destroying mines, they're pretty easy. So yeah, I've already heard that they've had some issues with Destiny 2's development. So that, plus the fact that they are on a schedule. I don't think they're on much of a strict schedule for Destiny 1. That's why they're able to delay it so much. Oh, I don't want to die again to you. I'm just gonna... Okay, Nova Bomb the shields. yeah, so... There's a mine. I'm getting distracted here. Basically, long story short, I really don't want another Destiny 1 situation where we don't get the game that they wanted to give us, because they've already... Are you... Not again! Not again, man. He had to just push me. You have... If only I had the Twilight Garrison, then I could avoid that, but no. Sadly, I keep getting pushed into freaking walls. That hasn't happened to me in such a long time, and wow, this guy... Okay, never mind. You are a potato. I've actually went ahead and sent someone a message just saying potato, just because they're freaking potatoes. And it's not my saying to call people potatoes, it's, I can't say that, you know, that's my thing to call people potatoes, it's Monster's thing. I don't think he'd give a shit, though, if I do it, but, you know, I've kind of caught on to sayings. I've tried to come up with my own sayings. I've done it myself, but for the most part, I'm just... God damn it. Oh, how far can you get in here? Dude! What is this? I had no idea this existed.
Seek mine.
That's cool.
Destroy them.
But anyways, other than talking about, you know, when Destiny 2 comes out, I would let. Oh, I do not want to die again to you guys. I do want to see it come out this year, but I just want to talk about some things that I want to see from it. The hottest debate on the market here is whether or not we get our old characters back. There's lots of arguments for it, and there's lots of arguments against it. However, where I am is, honestly, I'm neutral. I would love to get these old characters back, but then again, we didn't even have characters. We almost did, well, basically, we did, but it's, you know, it's kind of different. We shouldn't expect for us to carry everything over into Destiny 2. But that wasn't even true for the first game. Like, the fact that I'm grinding for a gun that you can't get anymore, like, the fact that I'm using this gun, this Fatebringer, for the simple reason that you can't really use it anymore in PvE, just means that it's like, you can't even bring over your old guns from Destiny 1 to Destiny 1. Oh wow, that Black Falcon guy was just, he's just carrying with the revives there. Yeah, he couldn't.
Go back to airlock.
You can't. Yes. And if you can't carry guns and stuff over from the game to that exact same game, like, why would we expect it to get transferred over to Destiny 2? I don't know if I'm explaining it quite good. That's just kind of like what live commentary is at this point. I'm sorry for this background noise, by the way. But, yeah, if we can't even. I know I'm just repeating myself at this point. But it's like, why should we expect it? Like, I would love it, but I would also love to be able to use this exact gun that I grinded Vault of Glass for a very, very long time, week after week after week, playing Vault of Glass, trying to get this hand cannon. I finally got it, and I got to use it for a few months, and then, same with Gjallarhorn, I got to use it for a few months, and those were the greatest months ever, best months of Destiny I've ever played. And then, rest in peace. No longer able to use these. Like, it sucks. It really does suck. But I think it could be more forgivable for Destiny 2. You know, it's a new game. My main thing I want from Destiny 2, though, is I don't want another from year 1 to year 2. All the guns from that game, I want to be able to use for the entire life cycle of that game. Hopefully, you know, being able to use your Taken King guns with Rise of Iron isn't just like the fact that it's kind of almost a rush DLC. I'm willing to say this is a rush DLC. A lot of it is, you know, rehashed content. The story's a lot smaller. The raid is a lot smaller. I'm not saying it's bad content, I'm just saying it's a lot smaller. If anything's big, it's the plague lines. The plague lines are pretty big. Punch you. I should probably use this guy. There we go, here's the dismantle of the mines. We're getting all the objectives, that's kind of rare. But yeah, it's really annoying on like. Oh, man. Yeah, that's right, just die. Just die, man. Yeah, I want to use all my gear. Like, I don't want another, like, okay, you can't use this because this is Destiny 2 year 1. You know, you can't use it in Destiny 2 year 2. Or if it's going to go year 4 and 5. You know, you can't use year 4 stuff in year 5. I don't want that to ever happen again. All my gear that I get, I want to use. Because, like, it took so much grinding for me to finally get the Gjallarhorn. It took so much grinding for me to get the Vex Mythoclast and the Necrochasm, which I didn't even get to year 2, the Necrochasm. It took a lot of grinding. I wanted to go ahead and grind out all the exotics before year 2 came out. I actually didn't succeed in that. I still needed super good advice. But I got that in year 2 pretty easily. Through the legacy engrams that Zero sold. So I ended up getting super good advice that way. and Necrochasm, but those are the only two that I needed, and those are the two I got in year two. But yeah, other than that, like, all the grinding it took for get all the exotics in year one. And by the way, year two players, you're like, whoa, you didn't get all the exotics in year one? That's sad. It is a lot harder to get exotics in year one. It's like, if you're to just play PvP like you do to get all your exotics in year two or whatever, it's pretty darn easy. And like, especially the first week of Xur, or was it the first 2 weeks? I think it was the first week of Xur. Three of Coins was very overpowered. There's no cooldown, so you could just kill a boss, kill yourself, kill a boss again. Very easy, very overpowered. I can see why they wanted to change that. But the main reason why you can't use your ones and your two is because they just wanted to change up things so much. Not all your one weapons, but Howls of Wolves weapons, you could re-roll, and the Iron Banner weapons from Dark Below as well, you could re-roll. And you had primary burns, as you can see with this Fatebringer that deals arc damage. You don't have that anymore, except for Zayla Supercell. But yeah, in year one, all raid weapons, sequel versions of Prison of Elders weapons, and Adept Flawless weapons from Trials all give you primaries with burns. The two House of Wolves activities, the Trials of Osiris and the Prison of Elders ones, would be randomized, and then, for example, and then the raid ones, they'd always be the same. Like, if you got a Fatebringer, it'd always be an Arc Fatebringer. There would never be a Solar Fatebringer, and there would never be a Void Fatebringer. But, yeah. So, just because the way they change out loots is... the loot system, as well as the way they change the upgrading system, where they use infusion now, that is the main reason why they... Well, that is just the reason why they did it. It kind of sucks, but that's kind of how things go. But, yeah, I just really hope my number one thing I want from Destiny 2 is to not have another year one or year two. That was probably the worst thing they've ever done. And I hope that they, really with Fusion Rampage, practice getting your spread, like, just perfect. Oh, wow, there's a lot of captains. You have to practice getting your spread as low as possible. Oh, God. I'm just gonna revive him. Did the other guy quit out? Seriously, did the other guy actually just quit out on us? What the hell? And, it's good to practice in PvE, like, you know. Like, that was pretty... That was a good burst. That would have, like, press-ramped someone. Fusion rifling does take a good amount of skill. I've seen people install fusion riflers, and, like, you know, you just have to hold down the trigger until it loops. And that's coming from a shotgunner, so... I took it with a grain of salt, but he had no idea. Especially lower stability fusion rifles. I usually go with range because I like, if you can practice controlling your burst like this, like that was a really good one, not so much that one. If you can really practice controlling your bursts, you can really do some major damage, and that's why that was a horrible burst, but that's because I was controlling it. It's forgivable. Hey, stupid captain. Dude, you're gonna die, don't melee a captain. You only live because I am too good at this game. It's just a delicious. Ooh, super. Die, stupid. Oh, I hit him way too soon. Just quick boop, boop, boop. Oh, that was a good one. That would have crossed map. That wouldn't have. A quick fusion rifle tip, you know, just zoom in at the last second, because. Are you kidding me, bro? You weren't the one that was carrying us. The last guy was mad because we were the potatoes. My deaths weren't my fault, man. That was a good one. Yeah, so you basically just have to, and then you have to find out the recoil pattern and just try to fight it as you're looping. And that will usually work. Ooh, I got two ether seeds. That's nice. So yeah, this is also easier to grind in year 2 and 3. Yeah, the guy quit out, that kind of sucks. He only got one kill? Bro, you gotta step up your game. I was doing all the work. Dude, wait, so I killed all the captains that were there, mate. Okay. So, he's being all sassy because I'm mad at him. But you see, I'm sorry, but I'm the only one who hits nothing but net. Who can I miss them all? Yeah, nice. You fought. You won. I'm not even gonna wait for him, bro. Oh, he died? I'm not even gonna wait for him. He's a potato. I'm sorry, bro, but you're a potato. So I got a pavement. I already got one, so I'm gonna just dismantle this one. Actually, I think I dismantled the other one, but I'm gonna dismantle this one too. Back in House of Wolves, you needed a treasure key to unlock this guy. Better come down here, man. Yeah. You have 7 seconds. I'm a dick, but you're a potato. So it evens out. Okay, he got everything except for that. Except for one of the chests. Alright, so will we get the Loner Rebel? This is the moment of truth. Nope, but we did get another futile gesture, so we'll see if this one's better than ours. And by the way, all the engrams that you get will decrypt into year 1. So if you get a year 1 legendary engram, you can get all the faction weapons from House of Wolves. You can get all the legendary weapons from House of Wolves. So, so let's see what we have. Oh, so it has both fitted stock. Oh, okay, so it has both of that. This is overall worse, so I'm going to dismantle you. And, so I will see you guys in the next episode. I hope you guys enjoyed. And, I'm going to go ahead and just continue on grinding this. And we'll see if we get the Loner Rebel. If we do before I record the next episode, then it'll be at the end of this one. Or maybe at the end of the second one. I'm not quite sure. I'll see you, and if I do, I'm sorry about keeping on moving stuff around. If I do indeed get the Loner Rebel and do it after I upload this video, I will just make it like a review video or something. I don't know.
Wait a minute.
I don't want a 6 dragon, bro.
I forgot how you command powers.
I want the queen's one. Not you fucking bitch.
By the way, what level are you on Pokemon Go Edge?
Pretty low.
By the way, what level are you on Pokemon Pokemon Go Edge?
Not very high. Okay, give me a Loner Rebel, please. Please give me a Loner Rebel. Please give me a Loner Rebel. Give me a Loner Rebel. Give me... Loner Rebel, give me a Loner Rebel, please. I carry the team. I got the Loner Rebel!